This video has been created thanks to MyWorld, a consortium programme fueling the West of England's creative technology sector and funded by UK Research and Innovation Strength in Places Fund. This video will guide you through how to build the DJI Ronin 4D 8K. The DJI Ronin 4D 8K is a cinema camera that comes with a 4-axis stabilisation system, including a Z-axis to reduce vertical camera shape. It includes a high-bright main monitor, a DX base lens mount, a DL mount, a PL adapter, and a LiDAR focusing system. It uses the image processing system CineCore 3.0 and Apple ProRes recording format. It can shoot up to 75 frames per second and can capture 14 plus stops of dynamic range. It has built-in 9-stop ND filters and uses TB50 batteries and Pro SSD media. It also includes a video transmitter which outputs to a high-bright remote monitor with a transmission range of up to nearly 20,000 feet. For purposes of this video, the camera will be built on a tripod, otherwise it should be built on a flat surface. To get started, attach a quick release plate to the camera. Attach the camera to the tripod and lock into place. Slide the right hand grip into the port on the main body, ensuring the pins match until you hear a click, and press the lever down to lock into place. Rotate the camera. Slide the left hand grip into the port on the main body, again ensuring the pins match, and lock into place. The gimbal has tilt, pan, and Z axis. Start by unlocking the tilt, pan, and Z axis lock buttons in order to set up the gimbal in the starting position, and then lock into place. Attach the LiDAR rangefinder to the bracket on top of the gimbal and tighten the knob. Connect one end of the focus motor cable to the LiDAR and the other end to the gimbal and tighten the screws to lock into place. To mount the lens, press and release the mount body cap. Attach the lens to the mount by aligning the red dots. And turn clockwise until you hear a click. To balance the gimbal, start by unlocking the tilt axis button to check the center of gravity. If the lens moves downwards, it is top heavy. If it moves up, it is bottom heavy. Adjust the tilt axis knobs and move the axis back and forth until balanced. Tighten the knobs and lock into place with the axis lock button. To balance the pan axis, remove the camera from the tripod and place on a flat surface. Unlock the pan axis button and tighten the knob. Using the top handle, tilt the main body to the left side. If the gimbal swings to the right, push the axis arm out and tighten the knob. If the gimbal swings to the left, push the axis arm in and tighten the knob. The gimbal is balanced when the camera stays still at any angle. Once balanced, lock into place with the pan axis lock button. Place the camera back onto the tripod and lock into place. Ensure the three axis locks are unlocked in order to switch the camera on. Insert the TB50 battery into the battery mount. Press and hold the power button on the main body for 1 second to power on. Every time the camera is switched on, the gimbal needs to be calibrated. Press the home button on the left side of the monitor. Press the stabilizer button on the screen, then gimbal calibration, auto tune, and confirm. Whilst calibrating, the camera will vibrate. To balance the Z-axis, loosen the Z-axis knob and press the 4D button on the side of the main body. Press the balancing detection icon on the screen. If the Z-axis bar is red, adjust the Z-axis balancing knob until the Z-axis is balanced. This will show as a fine line in the middle of the bar. Insert the Pro SSD card into the media card mount. To use the remote monitor, ensure the transmitter is fitted in between the main body and the battery mount. Attach the four antennas to the top and sides of the transmitter. Attach the four antennas to the top of the monitor. Insert the battery to the back of the monitor. In order to attach the hand grip, unlock the lever and slide the grip into the port on the side of the monitor and lock into place. Repeat on the other side. To adjust the angle of the hand grip, press the grip rotation lever and adjust accordingly. Press the button to switch the monitor on, and you're ready to start filming.